With its shiny leather case and hand-sewn seam, it looks like the traditional Kookaburra cricket ball, but at its core, the future of the game, a high-tech microchip designed to withstand the whack of a bat and deliveries faster than 150 kilometres per hour.
This is the ball telling us what's going on. We've never had that before.
Movement sensors inside the Kookaburra smart ball transmit accurate playing data to an app.
We're getting speeds from the point of release before it bounces and after it bounces. So for an elite player, they're going to find out stuff about their game that they've never known before.
We did try it quite a few years ago. And we couldn't do it because the technology wasn't there and it was too big.
It's just a demonstration that manufacturing is still really strong. And when you add that technological edge, it gives you wonderful opportunities for the future.
After 3 years of meticulous testing, inside its Melbourne factory, the 129-year-old company will debut the world-first technology tonight at Lord's in front of the Australian cricket team. There's likely a few more years before they'll use it in test matches, pending Cricket Australia's approval. But junior players and coaches could be bowling smart as early as January.
We really couldn't change the characteristics of the ball. We had to keep it exactly the same.
I think we'll be able to see a day where the ball tells us whether it's hit the bat or not definitively, and things like helping decision making for umpires.
Every Kookaburra ball used in Australia is handcrafted and assembled by up to 80 staff at this factory in Moorabbin. But its newest addition to the production line is sure to open up a whole new world of export opportunities.
And I can see cricket fans and cricket players right around the world, particularly in that enormous market that is India, wanting to be able to measure their bowling speed with a great Kookaburra ball made right here in Melbourne.
Lana Murphy, Nine News.